level positions, and employers aren't too eager to hire them. Mary Abje is a career coach, and she's going to give us ways to get those open spots, even if we're overqualified.
The big O word,
we just
right?
Talked, we just talked you up, so help.
Oh my, oh my. Well, here's one thing. Stop considering yourself overqualified. Consider yourself fully qualified. So that's my first tip. Stop using the word overqualified and say you're fully qualified.
When you're handing over a resume and you have a lot of qualifications, should you cut some of them back if you know this is a position you're overqualified for?
That's a great question, and different experts are of two minds on this. The first thing you have to remember is that we always tailor our resumes to the job that we're seeking, right? So we always should be doing that. We should always be tailoring. However, you don't ever want to overtly lie on your resume or leave anything out. What you do want to do, I call it, you want to take the depuffery wand to your resume. Oh. And you know how we often tend to make really great titles about who we are, and we use these great, you know, words and adjectives that describe us. You want to depuff those.
Well, when we're really young and we're just starting out, we try to make ourselves sound better than maybe we really are. Right?
And that habit sticks with us, you know. So instead of saying things like, I was the executive vice president of a five-person company, you might want to say, really, because we do this, right? You might want to say, well, I led this team, or I co-led this team or co-managed. So you want to depuff yourself. You know, you want to make yourself approachable because you want to be fully qualified, not overqualified.
And that's important, that word leading, though. Don't you think so many employers look for those leadership skills?
They absolutely do. But they are looking for team players, too, right? So they're looking for people that co-led a team or worked with the team. And what you want to do is don't focus on your big inflated titles. Focus on your accomplishments and your skills and what you're able to do on your resume. So, yeah, I would do that. I would go and tailor it. I would depuff it as much as you can.
I love the word depuff it.
I know, right?
Because you can kind of see through that stuff.
Yes,
the BS of the resumes where you're
exactly
like, well,
right.
Really? I knew someone who worked there, and that's not what you did. You know? And that could happen.
Absolutely. You know, so a lot of experience, I guess, is part of overqualification.
Yeah.
But the other thing is a lot of education. You know,
absolutely.
If you have an advanced degree, that people may think, oh, I don't know whether I can pay for that. Kind
You know, and that's
so
the
money,
tough one.
It's money, right?
I'm not really a big fan of lying about your or not lying, but you know, of not claiming your education. I know some people will say, you know, write additional professional training. I might do that for different certifications, but I would just de-emphasize. I would put it at the very, very end, you know, and, you know, you can put a smaller font, MBA from Wharton, you know, but I wouldn't completely take that away.
Well, the other thing is if you're changing careers, you were so great at one, but you want to make the switch, you do need to start entry level. How do you format that, or how do you get the word out that says, yeah, I'm qualified here, but I need to start here.
Yeah.
Give me that foot in the door.
Well, and that's exactly a great way to counteract the overqualification. So here's the thing you have to remember. If you might be thinking you might be overqualified or a perception of overqualified, you have to remember what an employer is looking for. Put yourself in their shoes. They are looking to answer three questions. Can you do the job? The skill question. The personality question, will you fit into our environment and are you going to be manageable, you know? And three, can we afford you? So when you might be on that precipice of overqualification, you've got to spin your answer. And what you just said, starting a new field, that's a great reason why being overqualified is going to be okay. In other words, you have to be able to answer that question. Are you overqualified and why will it not be a problem? Something like this, I just want to start this new field, this is a great opportunity, is a great way to do that.
And maybe you could de-emphasize the money question, say,
that's,
you know, I'm really, money's not that important to me at this point, I'm really looking for the
experience.
Opportunity. To, right, you know.
This weekend I was with a friend of mine who's a big producer, and he's hiring people, and he has a lot of, I mean, that's a tough time in the media field, and he was looking to hire another producer, and someone who's overqualified hired for it. And I asked him, I said, Michael, what would convince you to hire someone who's overqualified? He said the exact thing that you just said, Mel. And he said, if someone comes in and they're honest and they're motivated and they're enthusiastic and they just say, you know what, at this time in my life, this is the kind of job I want. I've been in the big, you know, leadership positions. Right now I want to focus back on the work and spend more time with my family. If you could say that convincingly, it could help you.
But how do you get noticed to get to that point where you can actually talk to them face to face? Because a lot of times at places you're just throwing your resume into a big pot.
That's
tough. How do you make it known that, hey,
how do you get to the interview?
Yeah,
that's a tough one. Like anything, you've got to have a great cover letter, and nothing helps more than getting an inside person to recommend you.
Okay.
So if you're really that overqualified, then you should have a pretty good network. You've got to get someone on the inside to say, give this person a chance. That will really, really help.
Once again, it comes down to that whole networking and knowing people.
Yep.
Yeah, that's the key.
And another tip that might help you is if your employer really is concerned that you're overqualified, and here's what they're worried about, that you're going to be bored, you're going to become disgruntled, you're going to leave for a better job once the market improves, sometimes saying to the employer, you know, I will sign a 12-month contract to work for you can also be another strategy.
Oh, that's a good one.
Because employers don't want to have to retrain anybody.
Mary Abajay, thanks
Love
for that one.
Good tips, great tips.
And good luck to everyone out there who may be overqualified.
Yeah, I think there are a lot of people
I have a feeling
like that.
Yeah. All right, thanks so much, Mary.